All right, Fox 5 Health News. Next time you go to the doctor, your checkup could include questions about how much booze you drink.
We just had a funny story about this. Joining us now is Dr. Zankhana Raval from Holy Name Medical Center. Good to see you, Doc.
Good to be here.
Yes, this is very interesting.
It's probably a question a lot of people fib on if they were asked by a doctor. Why shouldn't you, though? Why should you be honest?
You know, I think this comes down to just, to me, it's about communication with your primary care doctor, right? So find someone that you're comfortable with, that you want to talk about, because unfortunately, if you look at the last 10 to 15 years, we've actually seen a steady rise in the number of people who are engaging in heavier than ideal drinking. And even if it's occasional, that's still taking a toll, right? It's expensive. It's costing us. It's costing us up to 80,000 deaths in a year.
I mean, the numbers, I don't, you compare booze to everything else, they are crazy, you know?
And we're talking, you know, we're talking half and half. It's chronic illness, it's the injuries that come from it, drunk driving, the cost of it, right? It's costing us lives, it's costing us health, but also money. They say up to $250 billion in a year towards the court costs and the you know, everything put together, healthcare costs. And more than that, it's just be open with your doctor. Talk to them, right? Not everything necessarily needs to be written down. Not everything necessarily needs to come back to you in any other way, but you can have an honest conversation with your physician to say, how much is too much? Am I crossing the line? Is it causing me any ill effects? And that knowledge is actually going to be powerful.
Sure. You just go off the record with the doc, so to speak.
It gives the doctors a fuller picture of what your lifestyle is like.
Absolutely. Yeah, Please be open.
Okay. Gotcha.
All right, well, let's talk about this. Tick-borne diseases have reached a record high. The CDC says the cases of illness like Lyme disease have doubled in 10 years.
And I feel like we're surrounded by it in every good out east, like up north. It's all around us right here.
If you look at the map, it's actually starting to, you know, get more and more areas that are involved with tick-borne illnesses. And whether that has to do with the environment, the heat, the humidity, all of this, are the ticks actually surviving or spreading? We don't know. Or are we testing for it a little bit more freely at this point? Still, you know, if you look at the numbers, this is another one of those things. In the last 10 years, last year they set up to 60,000 people were confirmed cases of tick-borne illnesses. Compare that to 10 years before, and it was closer to 30,000 in 2007. So the majority of this is still Lyme disease, but there are other illnesses and other bacterial illnesses that are spread by ticks. So really, you know, this is another one of those things that we have to be understanding of good behaviors. How do you keep that lawn clean? What kind of protective clothing are you going to spray? All of these are decisions that you can make with your
physician. Spraying its own thing, you know, you
don't. A can of worms.
It's really hard, you know, if you're in a country environment like that.
We're faced with it, so we have to deal.
A lot to think about. All right, Dr. Zankhana Raval, we appreciate it.